Website crashes. They frustrate customers, damage sales, and harm team morale. So how can you prevent them? Our last quick questions with Cure video answer the question of how high online traffic can crash your site. So if you don't know why sites typically crash, you can check out that video here. But if you already know what causes websites to crash, let's jump into the six key steps you can take to prevent them. The first step is to use detailed website monitoring. Without it, it's not just your customers that get left in the dark. 74% of global IT teams rely on proactive monitoring to detect and mitigate outages. Monitoring is the blanket term for all activities that involve testing a web application for availability, performance, or function. These tests can alert you to potential failures before they happen and provide insights into site capacity and performance. Plus, if you miss something and your site does crash, monitoring is crucial to understanding what, where, and how things went wrong. This leads us straight into step number two, load test your site. Load testing is like a dress rehearsal. It involves sending increasing levels of traffic to your site under controlled conditions. Load tests show how your site performs when real visitors hit it in big numbers and reveals the bottlenecks you need to focus on to improve your site scalability. Simulating high traffic with a load test will help you determine the actions needed for step number three, performance optimization. Optimizing performance is essential if you want to handle more site visitors without adding servers or changing your application architecture. It lets you get more performance out of your existing setup and lessens the load on key bottlenecks. Some simple ways to optimize performance include using a CDN and making the most of caching, compressing images, minimizing use of plugins, JavaScript, and CSS. And you can take performance optimization one step further with techniques like offloading code to the edge before requests hit your origin servers, or by sharding resources by geography or key data attributes. Step number four is to toggle features. Most e-commerce sites are filled with interactive graphics, personalized recommendations, dynamic search, and a whole range of other features. Sure, these look great, but they're also a drag on performance. Well-prepared e-commerce sites can toggle non-critical features, turning them off and on for big days like Black Friday or a product drop. For example, rather than an advanced CPU-heavy search function, you could use a simpler search to free up the database for more important tasks. A simple website that can still process orders is far better than a resource-rich one that can't. Step number five is to set up autoscaling. Autoscaling works magic for businesses that deal with fluctuating traffic levels. You can learn more about autoscaling in our What is Autoscaling video that you can find here. But essentially, autoscaling makes your server capacity more elastic and reactive. Things scale up when traffic rises and scale back down when it falls. But autoscaling isn't a cure-all for preventing crashes for two key reasons. First, it's reactive, not proactive, which means systems often can't scale enough to address sudden traffic spikes. Second, not all components of a tech stack can scale automatically, meaning key bottlenecks can still be overwhelmed even after you've scaled up servers. That's why step number six is managing traffic inflow. What do physical stores do when capacity is reached? They manage inflow with a queue. And this same principle applies to websites. It's crucial you improve and optimize your site to protect it. But on its own, that's often not enough. The real trick is to control the traffic that hits your site with online traffic management tools. A virtual waiting room, for example, lets you keep visitor levels where your site or app performs best. It queues customers to ensure your overall capacity is not exceeded. And you can use it to throttle traffic just in front of key bottlenecks, like your payment gateway, database calls, or add to cart function. A virtual waiting room manages and controls what none of the other steps on this list can, the flow of your online customers. So to sum up, you can prevent website crashes with detailed monitoring, load testing, performance optimization, feature toggling, auto-scaling, and controlling online traffic with a virtual waiting room. If you've enjoyed this video, check out the other videos in our Quick Questions with Cure series, or head to cure.com for more content like this.